Hello.
Welcome to Drinks with Ron. I'm Ron. And I've made it back to Wisconsin. Have you time traveled here? Did you come from the last episode? If you didn't, I suggest you go back. It's Drinks with Ron like 280 something. Oh, I don't know. Look it up yourself. But I do recommend you go back in there and then then pick up here. Because that was supposed to be a two-part episode in the kitchen. I won't get into that. But that will show you a cocky drinking a beer at 11 a.m. Ron, enjoying his last moments. That last episode is a man walking to the fucking gallows with a smile on his face. That is Ron sucking in the relax one last time before 12 and a half hours on the road. And this is what 12 and a half hours on the road looks like. We left at 6:15 Eastern time, arriving at 5:45 Central. So 12 hours, 45 minutes. You do the math, 12 and a half, right in there. Yes, but if you haven't heard, Dance is back. Welcome to the Rainbow Dance Competition here at the fabulous LeConte Center in Pigeon Forge. We are so glad you chose to dance inside the LeConte Center, and we look forward to a week of dancing and making memories that'll last a lifetime. It was charming and endearing. Like, I really wish I would have gotten video. Like, when we walked up, my wife was like, oh, that's so, I like that. And this guy's voice and his accent is just, oh, that's great. Oh, yeah. Well, by day five, people were getting awfully stabby anytime they were within earshot of this guy's voice. So it was, it was a good week. Trying to remember where I left off the last one so I know where to pick this one up. But you'll notice my drink is water, so that should tell you mostly what you need to know. You'll notice I don't have my glasses. I lost them, so I had to make a 12 and a half hour drive back with no shades. Fortunately for me, the sun was behind me or somewhere off this general direction most of the day. A lot of mountains and the Smokies. God damn, man. I love the way the clouds and the fog and the smoke hangs in North Carolina, but you know why they named the Smokies the Smokies. I mean, I'm glad I got to see it. Like, it was so fun to drive through. I love the whole, like, it's amazing. If you like driving cool looking shit, go out there. Also, if you go hit Kentucky and shit, get off the main drag, hit the back roads. My favorite roads in Kentucky and Tennessee have all been these little hidden ones that squirrel around. But let me not dwell on, oh, let me show you what else. I mentioned it in another episode, I think. The Ale 8-1. It's the most horrible ginger ale I've ever had. And I like ginger ale. So, yeah, it's like someone just wrung out a butthole and just bottled it. I mean, not even just like a butthole, like a sweaty, like, you know, like a 12-hour car ride butthole. Like, somebody wrung that out. Like, oh, geez, I've been driving all day. I stop in Kentucky and my butthole's feeling greasy. Just wring that out, put it in a bottle. Hey, y'all, let's carbonate that. Shit. So that's my opinion. But, and I don't know what this says about me. But as soon as I tasted it, I went, You know, I bet they mean this to go with bourbon. That was my takeaway. So I'm going to mix it with some bourbon. And we'll find out sooner or later. Not today. At least not this episode. But let me roll her back. Man, Mr. Pants incessantly wanting attention. I know it's been a week. I love you, dude. But get over here and fucking get pets or something. I don't know. You're an audio nightmare. Yeah. Fuck. Jesus Christ. You made me take the Lord's name in vain. All right, come on. You want in that room? What's your deal? Penis. But I digress. So yeah, we get it into town. I look for my regional alcohols. I had to get Yingling, as you saw before. I brought a couple, made it home. Goddamn, dude. So we hit I hesitate to call it a winery, because it's just a building in a strip mall. They don't make the wine there, but a wine tasting place. A wine tastery. Was amazing. The lady was from Georgia. She was fantastic. And I like all my wines on the sweeter side, and all of theirs are. So I got to sample 6 wines, ranging from 9 to 19% in alcohol. The limoncello, it's not even really a wine, but it was 19 fucking percent. Like, 2 shots of that next to a shot of Wild Turkey is damn near even up. Like, that's insane, because it tasted like lemon and angel farts. It was just like somebody took an angel and put it over a cheese grater and just sprinkled that on top of some lemons. Amazing. From there we went to a distillery, although same deal. They don't distill shit there, I'm sure. I'm sure there's 2 distilleries in town and they source everything from there. Everybody slaps their own fucking label on it. There's probably 2 different mashes throughout the whole area. Maybe probably 1 for every one of those little stores. They're probably all the same fucking any hoodles. Had some fantastic drinks there. That was the only barbecue I got. It was from a strip mall distillery in Tennessee. Still good. The drinks were fantastic. I had a Lady in Red, because I'm a classy fucking gentleman. I was wearing this hat. Which consisted of a rye whiskey, pomegranate, and blood orange and pomegranate paste. I can't remember what the fuck, but I thought, you know what, that sounds good. And so I ordered that, and I said, yeah, even though I don't really care for rye. She's like, you want it with bourbon? I was like, she's like, that's how the drink was initially created. It got changed to the rye. I was like, yeah, give me the bourbon. And basically, it was really thick. I think it's that pomegranate puree. Is that what it was? But yeah, that was really fucking thick. So between that and this blood orange, all you could taste from the bourbon was just a little bit of smoke in the back end. Glad I tried that. Got to see one of the bubble teenies. They blow a little smoke bubble. I'm assuming it's hickory. Don't know. Fucking, you could cheech mine up. I'd order one of those. Like, yeah, give me a fucking, I don't know, apple teeny? I get chocolate dessert martini. Cheech that thing right up with that smoke bubble. I'll give you a fucking $12. Anyway, Derek was with me. Well, there's a lot of us there, but Derek ordered a watermelon cooler, I think they called it. It was essentially a knock on kind of like a watermelon mojito. So I think it was watermelon and lime, no mint. I can't remember. I think they used vodka, but that was really light, and I ordered one of those too because I'm on vacation, and Hondo end up picking them up, so that was amazing. I was like, fuck, I was gonna order 2 either way. Now I'm really glad I did. So from there we went to some dance, and a lot of dance, obviously all about the dance. I don't want to get caught up in that so much though. I said we attempted to go to the place, I'm not good with words right now. The next town over, Gatlinburg? Larry Gatlin? Something like that. The next one over, that thing was so fucking packed, and that was on a Monday or a fucking Tuesday. Like, you couldn't extend an arm on the sidewalk on a Tuesday at 10. It was fucking nuts. And then we consumed some beers. We had a pool on site. It's nice. Hot tub on site. And the place we stayed, they're kind of condo units, I guess, and I kept calling it a cabin, I guess just because it's in the fucking side of a fucking mountain. But it was past the horse riding ranch. Apparently right next to a Burger King I didn't know was there for a week. And right across from Fabulous Dollywood. That was fun to watch. In the morning, a road coming into Dollywood from the right side would be backed up between a half mile and a mile and a half, depending on day and time. But if you would have just gotten in the turn lane and driven all the way down and then whipped a 180, you would have been the third car in line. I don't know if nobody ever figured that out, but every day, like, one was empty, one was, like, insanely fucking, like, you could save an hour and a half of your life by just driving up and turning around. So, I did look at the GPS, and it shows red both ways, so, I don't know, I think I'd look into that, because that ain't helping getting people into your park, Miss Parton. But yeah, it was great. Like I said, we're in the mountains, in this nice fucking condo cabin, just getting fucking hammered. I brought a bunch of limes. I didn't bring them. I spent like $150 at grocery stores while I was out there. But I bought like a sack of lemons and a sack of limes. My mother-in-law brought a watermelon vodka. So I would juice up lemons. Oh. One part lemon. One part simple syrup, and then one part of that watermelon vodka. And shake the shit out of it, the big stupid smile on your face. And then when you poured it out, you had an amazing watermelon lemonade, which I dare say was better than the watermelon cooler that ran about $8 a crack. And limes, of course, we made a lot of mojitos. What that taught me is that I need to invest in a juicer. My body was not prepared for that much citrus, and C, I think I'm finally burnt out on mojitos. It took a week straight of drinking them after basically 3 months of drinking them occasionally, but I think I'll finally have to step back from the citrus for a while, because this does not know how to react. But we're in the mountains. We thought about not bringing the dog because there was a very real threat of bars. And bar will eat your dog. And my concern wasn't so much that Ted would get eaten by a bear, but that I would get eaten by a bear when I fist fought a bear for attacking my dog. Like, I was just like, no, the bear's gonna snatch him up. I'm gonna run up like that lady. Did you see the lady? Fucking bear snatched her dog and she went up, fucking slapped it and took the dog back. I'm assuming she's Southern. I mean, she didn't say a word in the video I saw, but when she slapped him, it made a sound of, what do you think you're doing? No, that ain't what... Yeah. What you doing? What? Slap. So, that's more what I was worried about. We didn't see one the whole week. Somebody in our dance studio did. First night there, I think. Had to run back to the cabin screaming. Our place was great. Said people cycling in and out because we were by Fabulous Dollywood. And like I mentioned in the earlier episode, you forget how Jesus-y it is down there. I mean, we got Jesus-y people here. But down there, it's Jesus-y as a point of pride. And like it's a competition. Like old dudes do with their lawn around here is what most people do with the Lord down there. Oh, I see your love of the Lord needs a little trim there. My love of the Lord's looking pretty good. Landscaped up. So it's... you kind of forget that till you get down there. And we had some various people staying there. And the one people upstairs, they must have been a church group going to Dollywood. And they must have had an aspiring fucking track star with them. Because this kid kept running back and forth all week. It'd be... all fucking day and night. So this kid, I don't know, they either got him jacked up on Mountain Dew or he is taking straight mountain meth. I don't know what his fucking deal is, but this kid would not stop running. He had fucking lemur energy. So apparently, the parents must have snapped. So, awkward conversation upstairs where the guy has to apologize for overstepping his bounds. I shouldn't have yelled at the kids. And she's like, no, that's fine. You should definitely have yelled at those kids. He's like, no, shouldn't have yelled at my kids, but your kids. And so at that point, I went in the house because, I mean, the awkward was too much for me. But apparently after that, she said, oh, I got to talk to the Lord and ask for forgiveness for drinking and yelling at my kids. I was like, lady, if I'd have been out there, you don't need to ask nobody for forgiveness. You should have yelled at them fucking kids, and you both should have done it earlier. And as far as the drinking, don't worry about that. You have another beer, because you're dealing with them kids. The worst thing that happens is they got yelled at. You've done a mighty fine job, okay? You just fucking relax. You're doing good. And go yell at them again, in fact. Tell your fucking amateur Carl Lewis there to calm it the fuck down. But the highlight for me was they had a trip to Dollywood. I think the next day, probably why the energy was so high. But I can't remember who come walking in off the porch, but somebody walked and like had to come in. We're like started busting up laughing. And I was like, what? What the fuck's going on? They looked at me and all they said was, you're not wearing that Under Armour shirt to Dollywood. And I started fucking laughing, and it's Southern, it's Jesus-y, it's respect, but, like, you know, I made fun of it for a minute, and I was like, wait a second, though, I mean, that's Dolly Parton, like, I'm with her on this one. You don't disrespect Dolly, she's a goddamn saint, a woman's a saint, I won't hear a word against her, but yeah, we might have gone a little too far on the Under Armour, because at first I was making fun of it, and then I agreed with the lady, and then I was like, wait, what's a kid supposed to fucking put on to go to, it's an amusement park, is he supposed to go put on church clothes? You get up there and you put on your church clothes. I want to see those shoes. You will wear a button-up shirt on the water slide, mister. You will not disrespect Miss Parton. She is a saint. Then we started thinking, oh man, that's a country song. We gotta write that. That's no crying on the water slide. See a kid all dressed up, come off dripping wet, his Sunday best. Makes me smile. Oh, a nap will make me smile. I hope this is still recording. So I'm gonna shut it down. Hopefully it is. So for drinks with Ron, I'm a delirious from the road Ron, signing off, hopefully.